Doing some hard use testing. This is the knife. This knife has to pass the exam. It's a cold steel. They're known for their triad lock, so it should be very strong. And this SR1 Lite uses some cheaper materials, but they should be very strong. It's considered to be as strong as the full version with other materials. So let's see. Let's start with some softer use tasks now. So it can cut this apple, but it's not a pleasure to cut soft things. Put this there. The apples are for the horses. Now, this is some cardboard. It tears the cardboard, but it's not a good slicer. But you can slice, obviously, cardboard. Now, let's take this bottle. Things, but it's just not a good cutter. Let's see. Let's see if we can stab this plastic. Three of them. Let's take one of them first. If you can stab that. Obviously we can stab it. It's two of them. Two of them. Can stab two of them. Take this this metal plate, some steel plate. Yeah, very well. And yeah, this knife is some $60 knife from Cold Steel. Checking out for tanning. Now take this away. Oh, let's see if it can see if you can see that. Yeah, you can see it. Oh, let's see if it can. Seems like it can do this, but breaks. Let's see, it's pretty hard wood here. Hard this wood. Check if I find some softer wood. And yeah, before we continue, this is a folding knife. You know. Costs around $60 from what I know. Obviously not a obviously it's not a very good chopper. It has some 5 millimeter thick redstock, so won't chop very well. Anyways, get through this. Get through it. That's good. If you really, really hard to use this knife, then see if we can to work somehow. Yeah, let's see if it can do this check the camera. Yeah, looks good. Let's see if we can do how do they call them? Spine wags, yeah, spine wags. See if we can do spine wags. So if you do spine wags, you know, you hold the knife like this, so it doesn't destroy your fingers, you know. And we secure it with some tape. Fingers are out of the way, but it holds. Doesn't do quite so well. Yeah, seems to hold quite well. Not optimal. Thinking it would be better, but seems like it's not optimal. Another solution for that. Let's do one like that. You see here we have here quite nice marks there. Should be some decent findings. Button. Was a bit seems a bit really hard wood. Not sure if we can. Seems like pretty hard wood. What can we do here? There's some special wood here. Don't know if you get the idea, but it's somewhat too hard to pattern. Let's see. Seems to work. See, there are different types of wood. There are different types of people hitting the knife, so if you want a good test, then everyone will do the same test. But I think we did get a really nice test for this cold steel SR1 light. I don't know, can you see it? Yeah, should be able to see it. So the working order is very well. We have some tiny bit of blade play, but it's really solid. The edge is a bit dull, but the material seems to be fine. The 8013 MOV seems to be very fine. The tip seems to be fine. Yeah, everything seems to be fine. So this is not a knife that is made for light use or for everyday light carry. It's more for everyday hardcore carry. And the one thing that I don't like about the trial block is that you don't have a flipper tap and you cannot play with it very much, but it's very functional. The 0.18 inch thick spine is also very strong, but you cannot slice apples very well. You can chop apples, but food preparation is not great. But for $60 around, this is a fantastic knife.